NFL reaches new low when entitled player charges fan to start a fight. The NFL just hit an all-time low when a fight broke out during the Seattle Seahawks' loss to the Jacksonville Jaguars. But that wasn't the peak of the excitement that made the Seahawks upset and embarrass the entire NFL during their season of epic low ratings. Things became much, much worse than a simple fight on the field between opponents brutally going after each other. The true incident involved a member of the Seattle Seahawks charging a fan in the stands to start a fight, proving there's a serious disconnect between the fans and the players. If football fans weren't annoyed enough with the disrespectful protests, then now they've got this to worry about. The Jacksonville Jaguars and Seattle Seahawks play in a tough game with the Jags coming out victorious 30-24. The end of the game involved the Jaguars' offense trying to take a knee to end the game, but the Seahawks' defensive players rushed the Jags at full speed. Usually when a game only has a few seconds left, then the players in the match respectfully when the quarterback takes a knee and allows the clock to run out. This is much different than taking a knee in protest. This is simply taking a knee, allowing the time to expire, and the game ends on a peaceful note. When there's only a few seconds left and the offense downs the ball, then they do that out of respect instead of running up the score. The defense is aware of this and they usually stand up when the quarterback takes a knee. Upon taking the final knee, the players all congratulate each other, shake hands, and proceed to their locker room or do interviews with television reporters. That didn't happen as planned in this match. The Seahawks players went hard and that irritated the Jaguars players and fans. And of course, this happens to involve the previously racist acting black power fist-raising Michael Bennett. As reported by Breit Bart, trouble started brewing when Jacksonville went into victory formation, prior to the conclusion of their 30-24 win over Seattle. Seahawks defensive linemen continued rushing at full speed despite the Jaguars' attempts to kneel the ball. According to ESPN, after the first play, Seahawks defensive Michael Bennett and Jaguars center Brandon Linter wrestled each other on the ground. Jaguars running back Leonard Fournette shoved Bennett during the ensuing melee. Those two were also flagged for unnecessary roughness while Seattle's Sheldon Richardson was ejected for throwing a punch. Seahawks defender Quinton Jefferson got ejected on the next play. Even Seahawks head coach Pete Carroll drew an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty for running out to midfield to break up a second fight, an altercation which earned Seattle's Michael Bennett an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. As Jefferson ran off the field following his ejection, a fan threw a drink at him. Jefferson then stopped, and began arguing with Jaguars fans in the stands. Shortly after that, another drink was thrown at Jefferson, this time the bottle passed very close to his head. That's when Jefferson tried to climb into the stands, to get after the fans. Was Michael Bennett acting out of line once again? The same guy who cried racism against police, but later was seen raising a black power fist during a game? It sure sounds like it. But he was well behaved compared to his teammate Quinton Jefferson. Jefferson sounds like he's quite a character and his behavior towards fans could be the reason many fans disconnect with their teams and contribute to low ratings. As a professional athlete, Jefferson should be used to football fans acting rowdy. However, he's also the professional in the matter and he should know how to control his behavior even if the fans are acting immature toward him. To see a professional athlete earning so much money to play a kid's game act like a child when he's confronted by fans who are still in the stands is just another reason that people will tune out of the NFL and add to the dwindling ratings the league is suffering through. There's always rowdy fans at a football game and players are expected to know how to deal with the fans if they're acting out of line. Trying to fight the fans, the same ones who contribute to the athlete's salaries, is irresponsible. This does not mean the fans' behavior is acceptable, but the athlete getting paid millions should always know how to act in the face of scrutiny or beer bottles thrown by fans. All Jefferson had to do was keep walking, go to the locker room, and enjoy the rest of his day knowing he probably just made more money in one game than most of us in a few months. Reid Bart reported what Jefferson said after the game. Folks in the stands was throwing beer and throwing soda, whatever. I mean, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I'm a human just like anybody else. I'm a man just like the other man in the stands. I'm not going to let somebody disrespect me, throw a beer on me. Just because I'm playing football, I'm still a human being. I'm still a man. I'm out there playing a game, and at the end of the day, it's a game and I'm a man. I'm not going to let somebody disrespect me like that. When asked if he felt it was the right call to try to go after fans in the stands, Jefferson said, "I don't know. Was it the right call for him to throw beer on me? I'm just wondering if it was the right call for him to throw a beer on me. Just saying." If the NFL ratings go any lower, the players could end up doing regular jobs like us everyday American citizens. Just saying.
Just saying.